What's up, guys? In today's video, I'm gonna do an indie beauty review of a brand called Dear Katie Brown. She does pressed glitters, and I realized in a tutorial I recently did on Instagram, and I had the look I was wearing a few videos back, the all yellow with a hint of glitz on the eyes, I was wearing one of her glitters. This is the shade Killer Queen. It's this amazing white base with an iridescent purple and blue shift. Looking at it here is not doing it any justice, but the point of this video is to swatch this as well as the palette of hers that I have filled entirely of pressed glitters and just give you the rundown of everything, my thoughts on them, you know, like normal review stuff. So let's go ahead and get started. So individually, these glitters retail for $5, but you can also get them in a palette format. There are a couple different pan counts. For example, the one that I have is a 12 pan palette. This goes for $33, and it looks like there's another 15 pan palette that goes for $35. So you get significantly more product for not a lot of additional money. It'll really just come down to the color selection that you want. And I wanna say, I don't know this for sure, but I wanna say that every pan or shade that is available in these palettes can also be purchased individually if this just seems like a lot of glitter for you. And part of what drew me to glitters from this brand, well, there are lots of things. Let me go down the list. First of all, pressed glitters just tend to be so much easier to work with and so much cleaner and neater than working with a loose glitter. Yes, it's a different effect, but for someone like me who just, the priority for me is getting a lot of beautiful glitz in like a very short period of time with as little mess as possible, this is what I like to work with. They come in like an undetectable, clear sort of medium. Like there really is no base to this. It's just a ton of glitter held together with this very soft, cushiony, like mixing medium that they're in, but you cannot see the medium when it's actually on your skin. All you see is glitter, and it actually has a pretty good hold. I've had some other pressed glitter palettes where the medium dries up pretty quickly, and this I have had for quite a few months, like at least 6 months at this point, and they are still very smooth, very much held together in their pan, so I'm not getting any sort of crumbling. And the hold in the medium that's keeping them together is also pretty good. I mean, if you're looking at like a super long day, 12, 15 hours plus, yeah, you probably wanna wear like a glitter glue with these, but honestly, anytime I have worn these, it has always been just going straight in the pan with my finger, dabbing it on my lid. I have zero fallout, and then I'm good to go for the rest of the day. I have a lot of lid space, but I do have like a slightly hooded lid situation where when I like look up or blink or anything like that, I have a little bit of transference. So that's another instance where if you wanna be very particular and specific, or you have a really pigmented glitter and you need it to stay put where you put it, then I would also go in with a glitter glue. But when I'm using some of these lighter shades or like this iridescent shade, I just won't even bother. I will literally take a finger and apply it directly to my lid. And actually, let's just go ahead and put one on now. I won't do Killer Queen since I just did that one in a tutorial that I will link, excuse me. Okay, gotta resituate a little bit. I'll link that down in the description box below. So today, I love every single one of these glitters. I think I'm gonna go in with this one down here. It has like hints of tealy green, almost a hint of bronze. It's like a mermaid kind of color, and I love it. So I am going to take my ring finger and I'm just going to slightly dab it in there. You can see there's like no fallout coming out. There's a good amount of product on my finger. Oh, I really should have clipped my hair back, but I'm gonna go and just press that on top of my lid. And I do have to like press and drag a little bit to get it to stick, but I mean, no fallout. They're just so easy to work with. The other thing, I mean, I like to apply with my finger, but if you wanna work with these exclusively in your corner, I do find I need to get like a little some sort of tool. Some brands, e.l.f.'s coming to mind, they actually have like a glitter tool. It has a silicone tip or head, so unlike a brush, it won't kind of cling to that glitter and not want to let it go on your eye. It just makes it so much easier to get a precise application, whether that's in your inner corner or if you want to use it to like do a glitter liner, you know, some really precision detail like work. So you can see, here it is, fully applied. There is, I mean, no fallout that I can detect, maybe a stray large chunk of glitter on my lashes, but just so easy to apply. Okay, let's zoom out because we are very intimate right now. Okay, now let's get into the swatches, because that's when you'll see the other reason why I knew I had to pick these up and why I love these glitters. They have not just a combination of different colors, like they're all multi-chromatic and very faceted, but they also have different sizes of glitters, which I just think makes a glitter so much more interesting. Not that I don't love a solid wall of teeny tiny little glitter, but it's just so mesmerizing to have like two, maybe even three different sizes and shapes, and you just get an even more rich and robust sort of texture across your lid. It just adds a little bit more interest, a little bit something more than your average glitter texture. I love that all of these have a little bit something different and interesting to them. And some of them even have like, kind of like Killer Queen, where it's the white base, all you're looking at is a shifty color to it. There's another shade here that is called Silence, and it almost has a clear base, but it's actually kind of a soft pink base. And then there are mermaid-like iridescent larger chunks in there that shift teal and gold and peach. And it's just, it's all so lovely. Each glitter is lovely in its own special way. And even if you're not a regular glitter wearer, I find that every time I use these, I use a good amount of product. So you don't get so much product that you might not ever be able to use these up. And like I mentioned earlier, these don't dry out quickly. Like, you have quite a bit of time to work with these before you might find that they have gone a little off or you need to throw them out. So there's no rush to use these if you just love a good glitter, but you can't justify having a wide collection of them. If you buy a pan or two or even a whole palette, it will last you a good amount of time for all your glitter needs, no matter how frequent they are. You know what I mean? So that's pretty much my story on Dear Katie Brown. Cannot believe I haven't talked about these sooner. I mentioned them on Instagram right when I first got them, but for some reason have just been slipping my mind when it comes to reviews and stuff. So really hope you enjoyed this review. Let me know what you think about these in the comments below, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.